still shining? That is the burning question in our heart of hearts. In a world plagued with anxiety, fear, and doubt, the beating of war drums and the clanging of swords, we wonder, is the darkness winning after all? Is humanity sinking into the abyss of our own sinful instincts? Or can we be saved by heaven's light?
Thank you.
ever seen God, but Jesus has made him known. Back in August, there was a partial solar eclipse that crossed Ohio. Many people were disappointed and dismissed it because they saw nothing except normal daylight. Others tried to stare directly at the sun, but that proved dangerous and of no help. Only those who used special dark glasses were treated to an amazing cosmic spectacle. For several hours, the moon could be observed passing in front of the sun. To try to understand the mystery of God is like gazing into the fiery orb of the sun without protective lenses. But the incarnation of Jesus in human flesh enables us to comprehend the glory and wonder of God through new glasses. He rescues us from being lost in the dark, and he comes again and again throughout history to enlighten our way.
Lost in the night. woman, Elizabeth, she felt a deep emotion well up within her and exclaimed, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior." In this hour and place, how can we be open to the infilling of the Holy? Are we too hardened or skeptical to receive this gift? Or do we feel too unworthy or ashamed to be a recipient of this grace? The great German theologian Karl Rahner wrote that each of us is a unique and unrepeatable expression of God's love. If this is true, and if it sinks deeply into our consciousness, then our hearts are warmed and lifted up. Each of us is special. We are all bearers of the divine in a world of crime and chaos. And we have a purpose in this ominous chapter of history, to bear witness to the light.
Henry Nouwen, writer and spiritual director, reminds us that waiting is open-ended. He continues, most of us want something very concrete to happen. We want to control the future and make it go a very specific direction. When this doesn't happen, we are disappointed and often slip into despair or disbelief. Waiting open-endedly is a refreshingly different attitude toward life. It is to trust that something good will happen to us that is beyond our imagination. It is giving up control over our future and being open to the transforming breath of God, who promises that a new flowering will occur out of our present darkness or pain.
Thank you.
Our day is so bombarded with bad news, fake news, and unsettling news that we hardly want to listen to any news at all. Turn it off, we feel like saying. As a nation, we are so polarized by cultural wars, distrust of one another, divided by tribe, race, denomination, or political party, that we are being drained of our spiritual vitality. Who can see any light at the end of the tunnel? Yet this is not a God-forsaken world. The tidings of great joy, the good news announced to the poor herdsmen on Bethlehem Hills centuries ago, still reveals itself today. Salvation can still break in upon us at any time. Hearts can change, doubts can flee, and relationships can heal. One of the great spiritual lights of the past asked, though we can't think alike, may we not love alike? And may we not be of one heart,